Humanity's facing a lot of challenges, and the greatest challenge I think I would have to say is energy. And that's kind of a vague term. When a physicist uses it, it means something very specific. But if you think about everything that we do on a daily basis, right down to life itself, it all comes down to energy. I was talking to a physicist about the explosion in science fiction and all those predictions about how we'd all be like flying around on jetpacks and, you know, going to the moon for vacation. All of those things didn't happen because they're energy problems. Thermodynamics is really hard to overcome. Those laws are very, very limiting. What we have experienced is an information explosion. We're definitely, if a new technology is built on information, then chances are it's going to come about in the next 10 to 20 years. Energy could put all of that at risk. We've got to solve that problem, and it's not just climate change, it's not just pollution, it's not just running out of oil, it's just that we can't do anything. We cannot continue to explore our world and improve the human condition unless we solve this problem. This will do us in. I think physicist Stephen Chu, who's now the presidential science advisor, got his Nobel Prize in a very esoteric area of basic research, switched his research focus to renewable energies, and is now the energy secretary of the United States, because he is convinced, as I am, that energy is the fundamental challenge that's going to be facing the human race in the 21st century, and that we need our best minds and our most creative people to help solve it.